Hey everyone, it's Amanda. Welcome back to my channel. And what do you guys think of the new background? I decided to switch things up a little for the new year. So tell me your thoughts. Do you like the new one? Do you like the old one? Let me know. So today's video is actually one of my most requested videos of all time, and it is a how I edit my Instagram pictures video. Before we go any further, if you don't follow me on Instagram, what are you doing? You can just follow me at Amanda Rach Lee. Recently, I've actually been doing a lot of Instagram lives, which are really fun. We play ukulele, we answer questions. So if you want to join on the next one, be sure to follow me there. But without further ado, let's just hop right into it. So let's just get started talking about editing. So there's two main types of photos that I wanted to talk about. There's the ones that require a lot of editing and altering, and then there's the ones that kind of just require a filter. Now, we'll just start off with the filter because that's the easiest. Obviously, I use ViscoCam because who doesn't use ViscoCam? It's my ride or die, it's the best. Definitely highly recommend it, but I'm pretty sure all of you guys use ViscoCam. So this is the photo that I'm gonna be editing. As you can see, it has pretty good lighting. There's nothing really wrong with it. It just looks a little flat and obviously doesn't match my feed right now. So the two filters that I mostly use are SE3, which is Street Etiquette 3, or A6 sometimes, which it just depends. Right now I'm really feeling SE3, and this filter is so good. It just bumps up the contrast, kind of mutes everything out. I'm gonna pop this down to about a 9. Now I don't really do that much with the photo over here. I will do a lot of this kind of stuff later on, as you will see, but some things that I will do is bump up the contrast, turn up the clarity a little. And this skin tone option is really great. So sometimes with the white balance in your photos, your skin tone can tend to look a little green or a little purple depending on the lighting. So this just selects the skin part of your photo and it changes it to be more purple or more green. So as you can see, if I go all the way over here, my skin looks more purple, and if I go all the way over here, my skin looks more green. So it just depends on what you need more of. Right now it's looking a little green, so I'm gonna turn this down to the purple. We're just gonna save that. Now the second part of my editing process is to bring it into either Snapseed or Facetune, and it really depends on the photo. But since this photo looks pretty good, the background is relatively clean, I'll bring it into Facetune. The main tool that I use in Facetune is the whiten tool, and you just use this to whiten the backgrounds. A lot of people do this, but this is great just for backgrounds that are already white but might just have a weird tint to them. So as you can see, I'm just rubbing this all over the background of my photo. If you can just see the difference there, it just takes out that weird warm tint and makes it more of a pure white. The next thing that I use is the details tool. This is just kind of like bumping up the clarity. So I will run this over like the belt over here and the fishnets just to kind of showcase those details more. Again, super subtle difference. Of course, now comes the time to post it. And what I use to plan out my feed and make sure everything matches my aesthetic is Unum, which is like the most life-changing app ever. I show this app to everyone who asks me about my Instagram feed and how I keep it looking good. And once they use it, they're like completely switched over and they think it's life-changing as well. So basically, it allows you to plan out your feed and it is amazing. So I'm gonna upload the picture that we just edited. As you can see, it shows you what your feed would look like if it was there. And you can also move things around and like shuffle it around to see how it would look like. Another thing that I like is that you can see how your feed would look like if you deleted a picture. So let's say I deleted this one and I deleted this one. That's how my feed would look. And it's just awesome because it gives you a nice visual representation instead of just guessing or posting it and deleting it, which is what I used to do. So that's that photo. Again, pretty simple. I'm gonna do another one. So let's do this photo over here, because as you can see, this is what the photo looks like originally, and then this is the one that I ended up posting on my Instagram feed. So very different, and I'll show you guys how I went through that process. So let's import that one again. Again, either SE3 or A6. Let's do A6 because we did SE3 in the other one. And what I do with A6 usually is I'll bring that one down, and I will also bring down the saturation of that because it tends to like make everything a little bit too bright for my liking. This photo is looking a little dark, so I will bring up the exposure A6 also has a tendency to get rid of some of the shadows, so I will also pump up the contrast. And then this photo is also looking a little warm, so I'm gonna bring that one down. You kind of get an eye for it just depending on your aesthetic, but I can kind of tell that the lighting was a little bit too yellow, so that's why I brought it down. Again, I'm gonna use the skin tone app to bring that down because my skin is looking a little green tinted. Then another feature that I really like about VSCO is that it has these perspective features. So sometimes if you're taking photos from a weird angle, it might not come out perfectly straight on. So I will use VSCO to kind of fix that up. So as you can see here, you can like kind of use the grids to line it up. I'm using the grids to line up that sort of table line and make it look a little bit more straight on. Let's just crop it just so we can get it more centered. Since this photo is a little less clean in the background than this photo, we're gonna bring it over into Snapseed, and Snapseed is kind of similar to Facetune. It's a free app. I forgot to mention that Facetune is not free, unfortunately, but Snapseed is, and you can pretty much do the same things. I actually like Snapseed for photos like this that require a little bit more precise, heavy-duty editing, and the tool that I really like to use is the selective tool because you can use it to select certain colors and edit only that certain area. So what I'll do, like this background, I'll turn down the saturation and I'll turn up the brightness, and I'll kind of do that all around it just to give me that white, pristine background. And as you can see here, over here where my arm is, it's kind of losing the saturation because obviously I'm turning down the saturation of the background. So what you can do is add another point here and it'll kind of reset that area. I can literally sit here and add so many of these little selection points because I'm very like particular about the way my photos are, so I could just keep going and going. Now, another great thing about Snapseed that I don't see a lot of people talking about is that you can actually edit your edits, which is awesome. So if you go over here, press View Edits, you can go back to the original edit you did and change that up. So one more thing, I noticed that the table is looking a little not as uniform as I would like it. It's a little more saturated over here on the left. So again, I'm gonna take this and desaturate this. I do this a lot with food pictures. I'll desaturate the table to make it match my feed a bit more because I don't like to have too much brightness in my photos. Another tool that I kind of like to use sometimes is the brush tool. This one is a little bit more precise than the select tool. Kind of similar to Facetune, you can use it as a brush. So if you see here, I'm gonna use the dodge tool just to brighten everything up, and you can kind of see where I brushed those areas. But another thing that I like to use is Tune Image. This is kind of similar to VSCO, the more precise, detailed, technical side of editing photos, so we can do brightness even more. I like that this has highlights and shadows because I'll sometimes pump up the highlights a tiny bit and bring down the shadows. And this ambiance section over here is something that I really like to use as well. If I bring up the ambiance, it'll kind of make my photo look a little bit more uniform. And if I bring it down, it'll kind of make it a little more contrasty. So I'm gonna keep it down here, kind of like the way that looks. If you wanna see the before and after just from the Snapseed, here it is. Makes so much of a difference, right? But I forgot to mention that when you're exporting your photo, you can have, there's two different options. You can save as a copy, which means that you can actually go back and change the changes even more, or you can export it and do permanent changes. So let's say I save this as a copy. So I'm gonna open that photo that we just edited. And if you see what I mean, you can still see all of the edits that we've done on the photo from before. And this is the saved photo. So even after you save the photo, you can go back and edit it more. So that's pretty much a general gist of how I edit my photos when they're kind of more basic and simple like this. But now onto the second type of photo, which I mentioned was photos that require a lot more altering and photoshopping, if you will. I posted a before and after of this picture on my Twitter a while back and you guys were like, show me your secrets. So I'm gonna show you guys my secrets. It's this photo over here. Here's the original. As you can see, there's like the wood floors in the background and it's just kind of like meh. And then here is the after. So I managed to take out all of that wood floor stuff, obviously make it match my feet and everything, and I think it looks pretty bomb if I do say so myself. So I'm gonna show you guys the secret to my madness and how I achieve this. Alright, so let's go ahead and import this into ViscoCam. So I'm just gonna go through the exact same steps as what I did earlier, so either SE3 or A6. I'm kind of feeling the SE3 for this picture. So I'm just gonna quickly edit this and speed it up just so we save some time. I'm gonna bring it over into Facetune. What I use to get rid of all of that weird, ugly background stuff is the patch tool. This is kind of like cloning if you're familiar in Photoshop and Lightroom. And what it does is it brings one area over into another one. So as you can see here, if I bring this one over here, it brings this area over there. So it's going to take a while, not gonna lie. But once you get used to it, you can kind of change like the rotation of the patch and change the size of the patch as well. Just kind of make sure it blends in. You can just keep adding these patches until it fills the entire thing. I know, guys, I'm crazy. Now it gets a little tricky over here when there's skin involved because you don't want to like patch over the skin. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some from this area of the leg, bring it over here, connect that leg area. You can kind of rotate it to match up with the leg skin over here. I hope I'm describing this well, it's kind of hard. And then you can just fill in the gap. And I would recommend working in big patches because it kind of makes it look a little bit more natural and blends in with everything a bit better. And don't worry about like the colors, like here, as you can see here, there's like weird dark patches. We're totally gonna whiten it later on. So everything looks pretty good to me in terms of the like filling in of all of the holes, but here's the before and the after. How crazy is that? Now we can start getting rid of those weird yellow tints with the whiten tool. So I'm just gonna go in with whiten and do my thing, especially over here on the right side because we have a lot of weird yellowish brown tints over here. So if I show you guys the difference just from the whiten tool, there's the difference. Now, one thing that I don't like about this photo right now is that the right side is a lot darker. So what we're gonna do is bring it over into Snapseed and use the selective tool. I know this is a lot of steps, but gotta do what you gotta do. So I'll just use the selective tool just to brighten up some of those shadows. I'm gonna bring this over into Unum, of course, just so we can plan out our feed. And here is what it looks like all together. That looks pretty damn good to me. This is the final product. This is the before, and this is the after. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much how I edit all of my Instagram photos. Hopefully this answered some of your questions or helped you out a little. Of course, if you wanted to follow me on Instagram, that would be awesome. We have a lot of fun there, and you can come join me on my next Instagram live. But other than that, just make sure you hit that little notification button down below. It's a little bell, so you can be a part of the notification squad. And yeah, I hope you have an awesome day, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye, guys.